Loteprednol is a corticosteroid indicated in the treatment of pain and inflammation after cataract surgery. In this video, let's find found. What is loteprednol? What is loteprednol used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking loteprednol? How does loteprednol work? How to use loteprednol? What is loteprednol? Loteprednol is a topical corticosteroid used to treat inflammation of the eye. It is marketed by Bosch and Lomb as Lotemax and Loterex. It was patented in 1980 and approved for medical use in 1998. It is available as a generic medication. What is loteprednol used for? Applications for this drug include the reduction of inflammation after eye surgery, seasonal allergic conjunctivitis, uveitis, and chronic forms of keratitis such as adenoviral, Thigesen's keratitis, vernal keratoconjunctivitis, pinguiculitis, giant papillary conjunctivitis, and episcleritis. Contraindication. Contraindications. As corticosteroids are immunosuppressive, loteprednol is contraindicated in patients with viral, fungal, or mycobacterial infections of the eye. Side effects. The most common adverse effects in patients being treated with the gel formulation are anterior chamber inflammation, in 5% of people, eye pain, 2%, and foreign body sensation, 2%. Pharmacodynamic. Loteprednol etabonate, LE, belongs to a unique class of corticosteroids with potent anti-inflammatory effects, designed to be active at the site of action. Animal studies have shown that LE has a binding affinity to steroid receptors that is 4.3 times greater than dexamethasone. Mechanism of action. Corticosteroids mediate their anti-inflammatory effects mainly through the modulation of the cytosolic glucocorticoid receptor, GR, at the genomic level. Preclinical studies demonstrated that loteprednol etabonate is highly lipophilic and has strong binding affinity to glucocorticoid receptors. After it binds to the GR in the cytoplasm, the activated corticosteroid GR complex migrates to the nucleus, where it upregulates the expression of anti-inflammatory proteins and represses the expression of pro-inflammatory proteins. Corticosteroids inhibit inflammatory cytokines, chemokines, adhesion molecules, and other inflammatory mediators. They also reduce synthesis of histamine, stabilize cell membranes, and inhibit degranulation of mast cells. Recent work suggests that the activated corticosteroid GR complex also elicits non-genomic effects, particularly the inhibition of vasodilation, vascular permeability, and migration of leukocytes. Half-life. The terminal half-life of loteprednol etabonate as determined when administered intravenously at a dose of 5 mg per kilogram in the dog animal model is 2.8 hours. Dose. Postoperative inflammation. Indicated for treatment of postoperative inflammation and pain following ocular surgery. Inventus. Instill 1 to 2 drops into affected eyes bid beginning the day after surgery and continuing throughout the first 2 weeks postoperatively. Lox. Gel or suspension, apply 1 to 2 drops into conjunctival sac of affected eyes QID beginning the day after surgery and continuing throughout the first 2 weeks postoperatively. Ointment, apply 0.5 inch ribbon into conjunctival sacs QID beginning the day after surgery and continuing throughout the first 2 weeks postoperatively. Lotemax SM, apply 1 drop of gel into conjunctival sac of affected eyes TID beginning the day after surgery and continuing throughout the first 2 weeks postoperatively. Seasonal allergic conjunctivitis. Indicated for temporary relief of signs and symptoms of seasonal allergic conjunctivitis. Alrex. Instill 1 drop into affected eyes QID. Steroid-responsive inflammatory conditions. Indicated for steroid-responsive inflammatory conditions of the palpebral and bulbar conjunctiva, cornea, and anterior segment of the globe, e.g., allergic conjunctivitis, acne rosacea, superficial punctate keratitis, herpes zoster keratitis, iritis, cyclitis, selected infective conjunctivitides. When steroid use is accepted to obtain an advisable diminution in edema and inflammation. Lotemax. Suspension only. 1 to 2 drops into the conjunctival sac of affected eyes QID. during initial treatment within the first week, may increase dose up to 1 drop Q1HR, if necessary. Do not to discontinue therapy prematurely. If signs and symptoms fail to improve after 2 days, reevaluate patient. Dry eye disease. Indicated for short-term treatment of signs and symptoms of dry eye disease. SOVs. Instill 1 to 2 GTT in each IQID for up to 2 weeks. Renew prescription only after eye examination under magnification, e.g., slit lamp, and IOP evaluation. Safety advice. US FDA pregnancy category C. Animal reproduction studies have shown an adverse effect on the fetus, and there are no adequate and well-controlled studies in humans, but potential benefits may warrant use of the drug in pregnant women despite potential risks. That's all the information about Loteprednol we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.